Frankie, we've sold a lot of shirts. You've left a lot of comments. We're going to catch up with you today on Boxmack After Hours. I've got 2.0 pounds of water here.
You gotta rest your doggies.
They're not too bad. I could stand, but why bother to stand at a time like this?
So we have a ton of business to get through. For one thing, we held a fan art contest.
That's right.
And you forgot all about it.
I remember it. I remember of it.
Well, we have some winners.
Yeah.
We have a runner-up and we have a final
winner. Okay, that's great.
They both got Rapid Max.
Yep.
We actually sent them video signatures of...
That's right, we did.
Me, John, and Nina talking to them personally. And we'll put those at the end of this.
That's nice.
So you can see it. The piece is called Bach Smack by Matt Gomez.
Yep.
Johann Sebastian Bach.
Yep.
Smacking Robin across the face in that sort of famous meme.
That's very good.
The story behind the art is that my girlfriend heard me saying Bach Smack and heard Bach Smack. This is what came of that mistake. Johann Sebastian Bach Mac and cheese. P.S. John should like it a lot as it already contains plenty of salt.
That's wonderful. I like it.
But the winner.
Yeah.
The winner Mac dinner.
The winner of a macaroni and cheese dinner who didn't actually get any macaroni and cheese from us. Sorry.
Did a little bit more than a Photoshop job.
Yes. An amazing piece of art. I really love this.
Josh James is his name. And what you see here is our kitchen that we're sitting in right now. And two giant noodles. A Junt noodle and a Frankie noodle.
Let me just tell you, there's so many things I love about this. The more I look at it, the more I love. I love the absurdity. I love all of that. But I love that the noodles don't really have shoulders, but they're still wearing clothes that have shoulders. I love that they're eating boxes of Junt and Frankie.
That is the core concept of the piece.
Yes.
Is that noodle, Mac is cooking us.
Oh, that's so good. I love it. And I love that the noodles are ridiculous and they're leaving a cheese slime trail on the kitchen floor. I love that my electrical panel is right here. The attention to detail is just superb. Really beautiful work. I love it.
Including the two different kinds of...
Yes. This is so observant. When I rebuilt the apartment, I did all new trim, and this is the new style. That's pointing through to the older style, the older house, which wasn't redone. So he captured that beautifully in this. Such detail. Really great.
Even your runner.
Yep.
There's even a lapel mic on there.
It's so great.
And I have this hanging above my stove.
I'm gonna get this one framed, and I'm gonna put it somewhere in my kitchen. Maybe I'll take down that wire thing and hang this there for a little bit. I think that would be nice.
We would like it to be a mainstay of the kitchen.
Yeah, I think that would be very nice.
His message to us.
Yeah.
I love your shows. I sailed in on the Reddit wave, and I'm having a total blast. Here are some fan art. And maybe if you like it, I may even be worthy of a Rapid Mac. And he was, of course.
He was, yes.
Which I didn't know of before your show and have been super curious of since your reviews. I even got you that sweet, sweet PNG with the uncompressed No Artifact Glory that a drawing colored with crayons by a grown adult male deserves in this modern futuristic world we live in. So this is crayon.
Yes, it's beautiful.
If there's anything else I can do to help out, I'd be pretty jazzed. I'm always happy to lend my artistic talent. Keep up the exceptional work. You guys rock my world.
Aww.
He also followed up with this. Watch your precious little hands, Frankie. And then a baby hand holding a noodle. Now, you have no idea what this means.
I have no idea.
Because you don't watch your own show.
No.
But
I watch some of them. I just really don't care for myself on camera, but...
Well, there was an episode not too long ago where, I believe it was the first Annie's.
Yeah.
Where I was cooking and you told me to watch my precious little hands.
Watch your precious little hands.
Thanks. And the truth is, I have tiny hands.
You do. Your hands are quite small. And I never really noticed.
EJ Massa, who is, you know, basically a producer on this thing, he's intimately involved in boxing.
Sure, sure.
He did a full family of pixel art.
I really love this. It says to me that we should have a game in which we make Boxmac.
That's what everybody says. And it makes me wonder, should it be a side-scroller? Should it be an RPG? Should it be like Burger Time? Remember that NES game, Burger Time?
Yeah, that was...
You actually just sort of make stuff. Although those are terrible games.
Yeah, they are, but that's okay.
One idea I had, I was, you know, in one of those hipster stores, you know, like Hot Topic or FYE, and I saw like pixel art of Star Wars on knit hats.
Yeah.
What about a pixel art knit hat?
That would be so cool. I wonder if there's companies that would make it. I'm sure there are.
Yeah, well, probably the same. We do these shirts through customink.com.
Yep, I bet they could
probably. They probably have it.
Yep, that's really great.
The daughters of our friend Emily that pop up here and there. Andy Brinkmeyer, who is 10 years of age.
10 years old.
She did this. Who's fatter? That was what her younger sister asked.
Yep.
It's a picture of John with a knife going through his head and possibly other wounds. And a bowl of Mac that, with an arrow to it that says Frankie Frame.
Okay, so she saw the episode.
Right. The other one's by Gray. Box Mac spelled B-O-X-M-A-C-K.
That's cute.
And dogs, because she really, we had dogs up until not too long ago, where both of them died in a very short period of time. But she always just wanted to see the dogs cook and eat Mac.
Oh, I see.
So that's...
There is actually film, if I'm not wrong, of the dogs eating Mac.
That's right, in Sexually Frank.
Yes, yeah. And I bet if you were really creative, you could cut it in right here.
It's very important.
Very important.
That our fans know that we have subreddits.
Yes.
We have a subreddit.
Reddit is kind of what we're most thankful for, because that's where our great viewers came from. So we want to get more of you involved and interested, and that's why Reddit's so important.
If they're already on Reddit and they want to do things like AMAs with us or anything like that at all. So our fan, Michael, is moderating /r/ Red Cow Entertainment.
Yep.
/r/ Box Mac will redirect you to that same place. Okay. Get over there. And what do you subscribe on Reddit? Is that
You can subscribe to a subreddit.
So do that. Speaking of major announcements.
Major announcements. All right.
This is the Kickstarter.
Oh, the Kickstarter.
The Kickstarters I really enjoy are the ones where people basically are taking pre-orders of a product that doesn't exist yet.
Yes.
So you have a loyal fan base and you go, hey, can you just pay for it up front instead of on the back end? And that's what we want to do here. See, I'm a big fan of optical media.
Yep.
I have a huge DVD collection.
That's right, you do. It's huge, amazing.
Huge Blu-ray collection. And all of my stuff has been produced into not just Blu-rays, but big-time Blu-rays with lots of special, and DVDs as well. But I would love to burn all of the Box Mac episodes or start to do volumes of Box Mac episodes on Blu-ray. And I know a lot of our fans would like to see that too.
Yeah.
And they'd like to buy a Blu-ray. And we can put some exclusive content on there, like commentary tracks and things like that. The problem is, it's time-consuming and difficult and expensive.
That's a lot of work to make a Blu-ray
to produce Blu-rays. So I'm asking that I reach a donation goal of $2,500.
Yeah.
What that means is like 150 pre-orders of a $15 Blu-ray.
Yep.
If 150 people want it, you got it.
You got it.
I haven't spoken to him about it yet, but we'll certainly ask Josh James to produce the cover.
That would be wonderful.
I'd love to make it look like a box of macaroni and cheese.
And I think if we do this, we should definitely make at least one exclusive Blu-ray episode. So that the people, you know, you can't get it on YouTube. All right.
And of course, Blu-ray, blue box. It goes together very well.
Yeah.
$15 is not the only thing you can donate. You can donate all the way up to $200, and everything in between has different bundles of merch.
Yeah, you get a lot of our, I mean, we also made proper films before Box Mac.
Four feature-length films on Blu-ray.
Yep.
Of course, our hats and shirts, which you actually, if you bundle them, you actually get deals.
Yeah, it's a better price if you go through the Kickstarter.
So, get us to $2,500 and you've got a Blu-ray.
Yeah.
Don't get us to $2,500 and you don't get a Blu-ray.
Yeah, it's that simple. You'll get your money back, you can go home and buy Mac.
How do you get to it? The link is in the description.
Check below.
So
down there.
I'll make it the most prominent link in the description. That campaign ends on February 14th.
February 14th.
So those who come for the Box Mac.
Yeah.
I hope you stay for the other content.
I hope you do too. Look, I'm in some of it, but even if I'm not, there's some really good content.
He's in most of it. Just recently, we posted a Star Wars Force Awakens discussion.
Yes, and I was present in that and participated.
We posted a video of you at your annual holiday party judging desserts.
I didn't even know that was going to be on YouTube, folks.
So what is this dish? This is an audience watching this man eat.
You know, we did a comedy podcast for years before any of this started.
That's right.
Most of it's offline at this point. Show is called How I'll Be. Why is it not online anymore? Well, some of the content sometimes got a little saucy.
Yeah, too saucy.
And we didn't always, necessarily need that on the internet. But we try to tone it down just a little tiny bit and make it YouTube accessible.
Yeah.
And so the Christmas video is up, and I hope people see it because we did a pretty funny dissection of Home Alone.
Yeah, I think it was really amusing. I had a lot of fun doing that.
EJ Massa, who did the pixel art with our DP on our specials and is just involved in everything we do. He's also doing all of his content on the Red Cow channel.
That's really exciting. When I saw that starting to happen, I loved his Fallout 4 review. I thought it was really funny. I play Fallout 4 as well, so definitely check that out if you haven't already, you know?
And do me a favor, just because it's not Box Mac, don't give it a thumbs down. Just because it's Box Mac.
I know you love the Box Mac, and I love you for it, but...
Like, there's going to be a Box Mac every Sunday. If between Sundays something that's not Box Mac comes out, that's not a reason to give it a thumbs down.
You know? People really do that?
Yeah. Like, the non-Box Mac content has one or two thumbs down. We were linked on theawesomer.com. Mm-hmm. They described this as Jonathan Hunt's Box Mac. So it's Jonathan Hunt's Box Mac.
Okay. Well, it is Junt's, I guess.
I call it Junt's Box Mac.
Yeah. Sure, but I like the proper name.
Is a lighthearted yet unabashedly serious cooking show. Here we are again.
I like that description.
Where he and his friends taste and compare boxed macaroni and cheese brands.
Yeah.
Man, we need to find our niche and get some of that YouTube money. Let's address this. Box Mac.
Yeah.
Gets about 1,000 views per show.
Sure.
Our organic reach, I have never seen it go beyond 5,000.
Yep.
But we did have the one Reddit episode that went up to like
55,000.
Yeah. Here's what I learned about YouTube revenue.
Okay.
Because I do monetize all of the shows.
Sure.
That way you don't have to pay for them.
Yeah.
Unless you want a Blu-ray. 50,000 views equals about $100 in YouTube revenue.
Yep.
If we've done 25 episodes so far and got on average about 2,000, and we're talking about we've maybe made $300 in this whole affair.
Maybe that's covered the loss you've been taking on shirts and hats.
Maybe. If you're ever curious about like how much YouTube
how
money,
much sweet green we rolling in?
Now, if you look at some of the top people on YouTube, the people who get hundreds of thousands every time and they put out content daily, you can make serious money on YouTube, but you need to have serious popularity. And we have... I mean, you know, our fans are very engaged and we appreciate that.
Yeah, but that's 1,000 people.
It's a joke.
Look, it's way better than the 200 we had
when we started. I recently dropped $1,200 on lights.
I think it's a great investment. I mean, equipment here at Red Cow Entertainment stays around for a long time. We really get use out of it. So
we make feature-length movies out of it.
Yeah.
LaughingSquid.com posted us.
I saw them.
Box Mac is a fun web series by Red Cow Entertainment where friends John Hunt and Frankie Frame make, review, and compare different brands of box macaroni and cheese. The series compares different styles of mac and cheese in categories like gluten-free, vegan, and frozen varieties. So the two of the three they named are Nina's.
Yes. Well, people like Nina. This is what I have learned.
Sometimes our fans send us pictures of themselves.
Do they? I've never seen any of our fans.
One of our longtime friends, Gary, and his sister.
Yeah.
Gary got his sister a Box Mac shirt for Christmas.
Did he? Gary being very Gary. Yeah, if you want to send in you and your Box Mac, if you happen to have a Velveeta costume, that would be lovely too.
Aubrey Jenkins, who sent us some nice Key Foods Macs.
Yes, and the colander, that lovely colander. Little colander.
That's her in her Christmas Box Mac.
Oh, she's looking lovely in it.
So she's got the Box Mac shirt and she's got the Christmas hat. Our friend Heather, she sent me an animated GIF of her doing this.
I actually like that GIF a lot. I think it's very, very modernly styled.
And one of our very dear, old and dear friends, Hannah.
Ah, there she is.
There's Hannah Carpenter.
She's living down in the New Yorks. Living in the New Yorks.
Other people who bought shirts include Cameron Weeks, mm-hmm. Jacqueline Treadway.
Ooh,
that's Jacqueline. Dean's mother. That was another gift. So it was a good holiday gift for some people.
Yeah, I'm glad they like them, folks.
Emmy Lease.
Emmy.
Courtney Velez.
Yep.
Keith Kochu.
Ooh.
Paul Welsh. And Tyler Newman.
Oh, thank you, everybody. I hope you enjoy your shirts.
But no hat sales at all yet.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought the hats are great.
And we've got a stock.
Would someone buy a hat, for goodness sake?
Other sales that we made that are not Box Mac related.
Yeah.
But were found through Box Mac.
Sure.
Jesse Lewis bought Having Fun Up There.
Oh, I hope you like it. It's one of my favorite. I like that movie a lot. I was trying to rank which ones are my actual favorite of our features, and it's tough between that and Sexually Frank for me, but it's definitely great.
Noah Miller bought Having Fun Up There and Sexually Frank.
Well, you'll have to write us and say which one you like more.
He thinks that we should make stickers. He's like a sticker guy. He's one of these people that put stickers on laptops.
Stickers are a big thing, aren't they? I thought that was kind of like 5 years ago or so, but...
Well,
I'm in favor of stickers.
If you're Noah, it's right. It's right now.
Look, no, maybe Noah is he sees the trend coming back.
Tyson Letter bought the Howawee Volume 1 and 2 Blu-rays.
Wow, I wouldn't have expected anyone would buy those.
And Catherine Cento, on behalf of Sal Cento, who's a big fan, bought the Howawee Volume 1.
Well, wonderful. Blu-ray. Thank you, everybody.
We also sometimes get pictures of kids watching.
Yeah, well, it pleases me greatly that the show is family-friendly, Frankie.
Here are John O'Brien's children, watching.
Yeah. Aw, look at that. They're so cute.
Kyle Gage, an old friend.
Yeah.
He made a GIF.
That's pretty excellent.
Thank you, Kyle. That's wonderful.
I work with people who watch it on the reg as well.
My coworkers also enjoy the show.
Tom Barry made a gif of you, Tentative John.
Tentative John. You know, I look a little like constipated.
Little uncertain of what was just said.
Yeah.
And in a business environment, that can be used.
Has it been used in your business environment yet?
At least once. Emily, once again, she was helping her kids with their homework.
Yeah.
And there was some sort of alphabet book, and they came across this.
This is strange. This is like Russian art, it looks like to me.
N for noodles.
N for noodles. I approve. Full noodly.
Ashley Kofel, big fan.
Yep.
I got a comment from her once.
Yeah.
That said, I blame you. Today on Boxmac.
Yeah, it spirals actually in that box. Try some three cheese, everybody.
You have a theory about three cheese that sometimes it gets kind of like lost in the bag.
Yeah, I think it does. I think if you're going to go cheap, you usually buy a store brand. If you're going to go better, you usually buy a deluxe. It's kind of stuck in the middle.
Old friend Jeremy Broder.
Yeah,
said,
I remember him.
Just saw my first episode of Boxmac today, and it's my new favorite show. I couldn't care less about mac and cheese, but the comedic chemistry is great.
That's wonderful, but you do need to care about macaroni and cheese, please.
It was responded to by your sister's boyfriend, Matt Kirkhoff.
Okay.
Who said, same here, I want to see a Chinese mac and cheese.
Whoa.
Which is interesting. I don't think it exists.
I don't know if it exists or not. I have no idea.
TJ Dozer Barnes, a big fan from the internet, he sent us this. I actually received this from a few people. It's a gridded,
this is beautiful.
A gridded series of graphics of mac and cheese.
Actually, this one off to the middle looks like Boston Market used to.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so good.
I
miss it.
Oren Bertrand says, no noodles.
Why does he say no noodles?
I don't know, but he wanted to say it.
All right, no noodles.
These are actually all from Facebook. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go through each platform.
Oh wow.
Shadi Matar.
That's quite a name. It's fancy.
And excuse me, there's gonna be a lot of names here. I'm gonna do my best, but I might not know how.
Frankie's no nameologist.
They showed a picture of a rapid and said, "I was really tempted to buy this. Love the Boxmac series. Great channel." It sounds like maybe they didn't buy it.
No, they didn't buy it. But they saw a rapid and they thought of us, which warms the cockles of my heart.
It warms the cockles of my heart.
I know the feeling, sir.
Maybe below the cockles, in the subcockle area.
He also wants to know, is the Boxmac theme an original composition or is it from a copyright-free music site?
Well, depends which Boxmac theme you're talking about.
The classic one, the one that's in every single episode up to this point.
Is.
The. Came from a, I didn't want to ask you to have to do an original composition.
No.
So we just ripped something called, I think it was called Sitcom Music.
Yeah.
Since then, we did the Christmas special.
Yes.
Where we produced a sitcom theme, Boxmac,
your parents cut you off. Which Frankie designed the bass melody for. You recorded it to me, I sent it to me, he sent it to me, and I actually did the instrumentation for that, and then you did the lyrics over it.
It sounds lusciously 80s.
Oh, it does.
A nice sax.
Very
80s. So, the very occasional guitar riff.
Yeah.
It's really good.
It was some of my best recent musical work. I used to do a lot of compositions, I don't really anymore, so.
If you watch Abo the Hue-Monkey, one of our four features, John did the entire score.
Yeah, there's a lot of music in that movie.
And that's some of your best.
Yeah.
We've been talking about maybe swapping out the main theme with our theme.
Now, maybe try it and see if people like get up all up in arms. Like, what the hell?
It could be they've settled into a ritual.
Yeah.
You know,
I don't know.
Do I need to like redesign the opening? Is it like,
I love that opening so much though. Okay. I
do you know where the style of that came from?
No.
When I was in high school,
yep.
Just getting into video. We did a little like show called Westport Weekly. It was like a town-based show. The video teacher, I think he might have taken it from either a past class or even
Right, it is from that.
Yes, it's from that. And
I remember I stole that format for a different project. Which was
the Steve Ouellette thing?
No. Steve Ouellette. That's what it was. We did a little promo video for a local politician.
But yeah, they're all that same public access. Bryce Ament says, Sunday, I'm excited for football and new episodes of Boxed Mac. You guys rock.
Oh, thank you. So, I also like football a lot.
Sometimes they call it Boxed Mac, but it is Boxed Mac.
It's Boxed Mac.
I'm not a huge fan of football.
Yeah.
But I think one thing that does appeal to me about football is like snack food and
sure, the
Super Bowl parties and stuff.
Yeah.
I do kind of dig that. Like, conventional wisdom says if you're trying to get noticed in, you know, with social media or with the YouTube channel, Sunday is actually the worst day to post.
Yeah.
But for us, it's like comfort food. It goes with what they're doing. Yeah, you know, what they're doing.
So. Yep, that's great.
And at this point, we've built a habit. Yeah. So you wouldn't want to break the habit. No. Luann Ament, who I'm assuming is a relative, a fan as well, she says, love you both.
Aw, thank you, Luann.
Dean Treadway, old friend Dean Treadway, asked us, did you guys see the new episode of Chopped? It's an all mac and cheese episode. No, I did not see it.
I didn't either. I don't usually watch much cooking TV.
No. Derek Schweigert says, because I love the show so much and because you can't produce enough content to satisfy my cravings, paren, more, more, more. Can you recommend Box Mac-esque shows and programming? Favorite YouTubers and shows?
You certainly have some ones that you are very fond of, right?
Yeah, it has nothing to do with mac and cheese.
No, no.
You know, I like Angry Video Game Nerd. I like JonTron. I like Shmo Yoho.
Yeah.
I like...
I love those...
Screen Junkies.
Yeah, I love Every Frame of Painting.
Yeah, I love them.
Not a lot of stuff that's kind of like Box Mac.
I like filmmaking type stuff.
Yeah, filmmaking stuff is mostly what I watch.
All right, so this is the part where you get to hear your name said out loud.
Okay. Frankie's going to plow through a bunch of names.
These are common commenters and fans on Facebook.
Oh.
Molly Paveo, who we actually went to school with, and she actually just lost her husband very recently around the holidays.
Oh.
So I know you're going through a tough time, but maybe we can make you laugh a little bit. With some
a little bit of mac.
Mac and cheese. But best to you and your family, seriously. Heather Curry, Matt Woodward, Justin Welling, Caitlin Pacheco, who's Sam Tex's girlfriend. We've mentioned him before. By the way, I'm trying not to mention people we've already mentioned. This is a fresh batch.
Fresh batch.
J.R. Molina, he, I believe, saw Having Fun Up There in Austin when we screened in Austin. So, yeah. Kieran Hunt, Ben White, John Davis, Jennifer Martise, Sal Cento, who wanted to watch our movies and listen to our podcast. That's why he bought those Blu-rays that
wonderful.
I mentioned earlier. Dave Galuski.
He works with me.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Nate Duarte, Daniel Dides, he works with you.
They all do. Those last three.
Chad Dierks, John Ryan, Christine Ross, Tim and Andrea Wachlowski, Mary Schmell, Jeff Schmidt, Harris Valerie, Eric Allen, Joseph Clark, Brandy Best, Jason Oldenburg. He's actually been a Red Cow fan for a very long time.
For a long time?
Like back like 10 pounds A-ball.
Wow, that's
like
cool.
He found us through like Troma or you know whatever.
Oh, wow.
Jade Harris, who's like one of our biggest podcast fans, almost part of the family. Joseph Simpson, Lynn Treadway, who I mentioned, she bought a shirt for Dean.
Yep.
Mallory Hoff, who is like a newscast, like an actual newscaster.
Really?
And you can hear me interview her on one of our other podcasts.
Yes, Discount Film School.
Discount Film School.
Which is another great, you should check that out. It's much more film focused than any of this, but we love film too.
It's talking to actors, talking to teachers, talking to on-screen personalities, other filmmakers, cinematographers, all that sort of stuff.
Yep.
Ashley Blum, she does a blog called QuarterLifeCrisisCuisine.com. And she, we had like one class together in college, and I really haven't spoken to her since then.
Yep.
But she said she's a huge fan. She'd love to come on here.
Oh, wonderful.
And she's got some things to say about Homestyle Mac.
Yeah.
James Berger, we went to school together as well. Erica Mattman, we went to grad school together.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Pereira, Justin Sharifapour, Raquel Santos, David Jacutis, Herbert Brinkmeyer, that's the grandfather to those kids I was talking about earlier.
Really?
And Emily's dad.
Yeah.
John Booten and Andrew Phelan, my former boss.
John Booten likes my, I haven't, you know, John Booten, I went to school with him.
Oh, is that who that is?
Yeah, I haven't talked to him in a long time. Hey, John.
That's what happens when you plaster yourself on YouTube.
I guess so.
Moving on to Instagram, and you can follow us on Instagram at Red Cow Entertainment, and they should. Because
please do. For noodles' sake.
Sometimes we're shooting things, John.
Yeah.
We don't necessarily want people to see quite yet.
Yeah.
Like maybe we're shooting a Christmas special.
Sure.
And we're taking some stills and we wouldn't want to put them on Facebook.
Yeah.
But we do put them on Instagram.
We did. With that very day, they were right there. And you would be able to know there's something exciting coming well before the promo came out. So you could see exclusive stuff. Plus, I'm getting access to there. Sometimes I'm out and about, I see something wonderful, I'm going to put a little something up.
Yeah.
So I'm going to use social media.
Okay, in terms of like Instagram fans,
Air
Blastered is our guy.
Yeah.
I just gave you that anecdote about how we were posting things as we were shooting.
Yeah.
The Christmas special. Well, there's a line you have in that show. Chris Mac Cookies is what you say. That was not in the script.
Right, it wasn't.
We posted a graphic of the Chris Mack cookies.
Yep.
And he said, hey, Chris Mack cookies.
Yeah.
And right then and there, because we liked the
word. We pulled it back in, and it's in the show.
So you can help write the show.
Yeah, you can, literally. I mean, if you see us, you know, we actually do read that stuff. We love reading comments from everybody, so. Right.
We read it all. There's actually not one comment that we don't read.
Oh, yeah, everyone gets read.
And many of them get responded to, as I'm sure you've seen.
Yep.
He also said, it's my favorite show, not just YouTube, but my favorite show.
Yeah.
I don't care about Game of Thrones, Walking Dead, Lost, The OC, 90210. He conjured some old shows. Give me new episodes of Box Mac.
Wow, that's really nice. You don't need to spend millions of dollars an episode. You can spend, like, what do we spend, $8?
Miranda Singh Fan sent me a message, said, hey, I really enjoy all the videos you post on YouTube. Mm. They're all high-quality content from the filming to the editing. I appreciate that people appreciate the...
The editing is very important, and you do a great job.
My favorite video series is Junt's Cart. So some people like Junt's Cart.
That's wonderful. I'm quite fond of that show. I love Box Mac, but Junt's Cart's a lot of fun. You
know? Junt's Cart doesn't quite do Box Mac numbers.
No.
But it falls just short of 1,000.
Well,
if you look
great.
At every episode, it's
that's
just
wonderful.
Short of 1,000.
Yeah.
There really is a relationship between hits and Junt.
Yeah. Either you think so?
Yeah.
A clear causal relationship?
I think so.
Okay.
I found your videos around this time last year. I was looking at Black Friday haul videos, and the Junt's Cart with the Kmart Black Friday came up on the side as recommended. Your channel is awesome and definitely deserves more subscribers. I also shared your channel with some friends, too.
Wonderful.
And, you know, if we want to get a few more than 1,000, you know, maybe share with your friends, right?
Yeah, share with everybody. Share with your doggy and your mother and your grandma, too. She may have big social media connections you don't know about.
Other big Instagram fans,
yep.
Antonius Lacinus.
Antonius is such a powerful, like, Roman style name.
Antonius!
Antonius!
iBeers PB.
Okay.
Or iBeer SPB.
All right.
Pete Griffs. And
yep.
Nitty D728, who said, absolutely love the Junt's Carts and Box Max, keep them coming, great stuff.
Again, Junt's Carts first on the list. Maybe there's a big audience out there for Junt's Cots, which is in the wings.
It's just never been posted on Reddit before.
Yeah.
And Lilith Beast, who's Lauren Robbins, who I know from real life.
Mm-hmm.
On to Twitter.
To Twitter.
You know, I'm not a big, like, Twitter guy.
Yeah.
But some people are huge Twitter guys.
Yeah. Are you finally, like, getting Twitter? Are you engaged with the Twitter community?
If they engage me, I engage them.
Okay.
But I'm not one to be like, totally, this train is slow. From Brady Waddell,
mm-hmm.
Just discovered you guys today, and I am binging on all your content.
Binging.
Truly high-quality editing and personality.
I hear we are good for binging.
You know, it is a very consumable show, and all. Yeah. It's very watchable. It's more watchable, apparently, than anything else I've ever made. Sam Haynes,
mm-hmm.
At Sam Haynes, actually obsessed with Box Macaroni and Cheese. Hashtag, I need about 3B.
Now, that's John, a great hashtag.
I do get a lot of tweets and messages where people refer to B just kind of offhandedly. They use your terminology of
yeah,
B.
Yeah, B.
Is that weird for you?
No.
That people are talking like you?
No, it's good. I approve.
All right.
Bring out your B. Bring out your B.
The following series of tweets are just bizarre.
Okay.
They're all from at Killa Connor.
Okay, Killa Connor.
The first one was, yo, f***ing mac and cheese and
whoa.
We start off a little aggressive.
Okay, but look, he's on target.
The next, whatever happened to the Rapid Mac Cooker review episode? How about a will a normal bowl work instead? Also, Deluxe Mac in it? Well, we've done Deluxe Macs in Rapid Macs before.
Yes.
And it works fine.
And I actually, yeah, you did it. You've done it for an office party, even.
Right. We did, in fact, do a Rapid Mac review episode. Of course we did. It's one of our biggest episodes.
Yeah, but what we didn't do is what he's talking about, which is it just a bowl?
Right. Right.
And that's something we need to investigate. Yeah.
He watched it. He said, just watched it. The ending threw me off, though. I don't know what that means. So I responded with, just trying to keep you on your toes.
Okay.
Brandy Best,
yep.
At OO Brandy says, I constantly crave Kraft mac and cheese because of at Red Count Ent. Thanks, guys. And you can follow us at Red Count Ent.
Yes. Please do it.
Matthew Lubert says, making home-style mac and cheese. It's accompanied by a lot of, oh, noodles, and calling my girlfriend Frankie.
I'm kind of endearing, I find that endearing, don't you?
Yeah,
it's very nice.
May everybody's girlfriends be Frankie. And then I asked him to send me a picture of the finished product, and he sent me this.
Lovely. It's got breadcrumbs, though. Don't, why'd you put breadcrumbs?
I'm a little bummed about that, but it looks like some of his more gooey parts look pretty good.
Yeah.
Nathan C. at N. Castell. Watching at Red Cow and Box Mac, And we had to pause to make some. Best YouTube show out, out there today.
An accompanying GIF?
Yeah, there's...
them watching Boxman.
Evidence of them watching Boxman.
Yeah. Full screen.
Yeah, so full attention.
Yeah.
It's not even, like, minimized somewhere.
Yeah, off of the fourth monitor.
Right. At DellLB30,
yep.
I've been inspired by At Red Cow Ent to buy a few bees of mac and cheese to see how they compare, but the selection available in England is poor.
Mm. I certainly wouldn't mind the convenience of a boxed frozen mac. No store seems to stock them.
Oh, sag then. You know, we've got these UK Macs coming up, and I'm really excited about not just the Macs, but doing a UK accent for the whole show.
Yes.
That's going to be my funnest part.
Tina Matar at Tignar. Says, question, what are your thoughts on Panera's Mac? And I told her I liked it. It's gooey.
Yeah, I did actually have it just recently for the first time. And I thought it was pretty good. Very expensive, though.
If you want a large, it's $8.99.
Yeah, it's big bucks.
And it's also not that big.
It's not that big. It does fill you up pretty good because it's so cheesy. It was a little heavy for me. It was a little too much, but I did like it.
Doesn't really work well as a side.
Yeah.
You might want it just by itself.
Yeah. Yeah. One of the best store Macs that I know you can get.
And when I responded, she says, that was my first time having it. A little on the salty side for me. But I usually don't add much salt to my food anyways.
Oh, not me, baby.
Did you notice Panera being any extra salty?
No, it was reasonable.
Then later, she mentioned us. And I just want to... I became kind of peripheral to a conversation she was having with her Twitter audience.
Yeah.
Doing our own box Mac. Never had either of them. I don't know which one she was referring to. Inspiration by At Red Cow Ent. Do you think store brand will hold up? Somebody responded, doubt it. They tend to have a different taste. Let me know. And she says, haha, okay, totally will.
Did she let them know?
I don't know what happened after that.
Look, it made suspense.
At Aviator Gaming, who has like 500,000 subscribers on YouTube, says, I love your stuff. Been on a binge for a while. Keep it up.
Thanks.
At Angry Kirby says, Box Mac is like the best thing ever.
Well, it's like it, yeah.
Box Mac is like best thing ever.
I love it. It's great.
At Rim Tiggins says, new hashtag Box Mac. Do we need to get a hashtag going?
Why not? I don't know how they work.
I just lost your mic.
Mine?
Yeah.
Oh, noodle. I will serenade you in the meantime while Frankie gets... a new battery with a short song about macaroni and cheese. Oh, noodle, where have you gone? You used to be creamy, but now you're all brown. Oh, noodle, how could you do this? I just want to eat you up. Oh, noodle, you used to be creamy. Oh, noodle, how could you do this? Oh, noodle, this song isn't that good, but what do you want for free? Now come with me, Frankie. Oh, noodle, what can you be? Why did you fall in the sea? Oh, noodle. Look here at me. We're ready to go on with the show. I hope you enjoyed that.
Well, now it's recorded, so we gotta compose that.
Yes, at least like it should be sung in a round, I think.
Yeah.
We'll figure it out.
An Irish drinking song?
Yeah. Oh, noodle, how cut.
At Rim Tiggins.
Yeah.
New hashtag BoxMac episode makes spending all day at work suck slightly less.
Oh, how nice.
So some people are not working and they're watching our show instead.
Good. I've seen actually people at my office do that as well.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, you know what? I actually sometimes have employees who do that. Like my staff.
Do you mind? As their boss.
What do I do?
You're this terrible, like...
Part of me wants to say, like, maybe it's time to turn it off. But on the other hand, they're really enjoying it.
I like it.
I wanted to do something kind of like fan participatory for the for the Christmas one. I asked that people to send in videos of them talking about their home style recipes, and not a take-a. Not one take-a.
Why nobody?
A few people had some thoughts. Yeah. Amy Bruno Hernandez had some thoughts. Tyler Tripp had some thoughts. Ashley Blum, who I mentioned a moment ago, QuarterLifeCrisisCuisine.com. Mm-hmm. Her big thing is, she says the trick is use gnocchi.
Yeah. I don't know. I think they'd be too thick, too meaty, too...
Well, she told me she's dying to co-host.
Yeah, I'd love to have her.
Not school us, but yeah, work with
just
us.
Just work with us, yeah.
And to that same end, I also wanted people to record some voiceovers for the beginning when we were doing the comments and stuff, and not a take.
Look, we love you. We want more interaction with you. We love our fans.
Dave Goloski, who I guess you work with, he was like, oh, I'll send you a clip, and he never did. Nah, well, I was chickened out.
That's okay.
People we hear from on YouTube all the time.
Okay.
Afro Ninja 720, see you there all the time. Air Joe 49, Brennan Oscar Part. I see you all the time. He's one of the people who encourage us to make more of these after hours.
Oh, I hope you like the after hours.
Demo Monster 7 says it's one of the his favorite series on YouTube. Mm-hmm. Josh Null Entry, I see him all the time.
Yeah.
Nigel Serafin says this level of production value for such a banal concept is hilarious. love it. Flesh Sandwich. He posts almost all the time. Yep. His avatar is of Mike Stilclasa from Red Letter Media. That's one of the other YouTube personalities I very much like. He's the Plinkett Reviews.
Yep.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Everybody loves Plinkett. Deck Control. Mm-hmm. Trent McGinnis. Yep. XXDrew333XXX. Now, I mentioned him last time on After Hours. I mentioned him again.
Why'd you mention him again, Franker?
He was the one who was like, you know, I'm starting to think that this show is for real. And I gave him crap on this show. I was like, you're obviously stupid. You don't understand it.
Yeah.
And he came back at me strong, being like, I was kidding. You don't get that I'm kidding about how you're kidding.
Oh, he schooled you, so Frankie friend.
We're in a humor meta.
A humor meta lock.
But I think he still watches, so to Drew,
yep,
with your very pornographic looking name, with all the X's.
No, it's just very like a number of years ago when you were 12, you made your username.
That could be.
That's.
I apologize. 80shorror.net. Mm-hmm. This is a guy who's been supporting us forever and was really upset that we didn't mention him on the last one. So.
Oh, yeah, we actually should have. I'm sorry. But so, 80shorror.net, wonderful. Thank you for your support.
Matt N., who also, by the way, we said, we were like, oh, people don't use RSS anymore. He insists they do.
I love RSS, and I not many things support it now. RSS is wonderful.
But it reminds me of like when you tell me that like things are well used. I'm like, no, just by you.
It was a big thing at a time.
Yeah. Brandon Tuck. Now, this guy's a little strange. First of all, he dissed our good friend Zach. He said that Zach brought nothing to the Christmas show.
I disagree.
He also, like, you know, it was clearly a joke, but he made, like, a weird, like, I want to make love to John Hunt while he, et cetera, et cetera. So between dissing Zach and the strange joke, I got my eye on you, Brandon Tuck.
You could just have an unusual sense of humor, you know.
Yeah,
people do.
Certainly I do.
Yeah, I do too.
I'm misunderstood by
people. I sing O Noodle.
You're right. But, you know, get off Zach's dick. John
Family friendly.
John Eleanor.
Yep.
Grimlock Hero.
Yep. It's a long list.
A username just called Noel.
Noel. Wow. He's the Noel of YouTube.
Pride Denied.
Mm-hmm.
Adam Jacques.
Mm-hmm.
David Laurie.
Mm-hmm.
Richard G.
Ooh.
Spizzer Spunk.
Whoa.
And Raymond Gerard.
Oh, how wonderful. Thank you, everyone.
There are lots of other YouTube users. And a lot of you do comment, but those were the ones that really stuck out in my mind.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sorry if you didn't get a shout out.
If you didn't, comment more, and we'll get you next time.
Ben Chrysler, who we mentioned last time as well, he says, after 18 episodes, John's Fawcett has gone through more growth and character development than the entire cast of Big Bang Theory.
I like it.
I'll mention, people really cared about your flow there.
My flow?
Yeah, people from around the world, actually.
Wow.
Like, literally, like, people in Sweden and stuff were like,
that's
I'm really glad he got that fixed. AirJoe49, he quoted you. Do we have any babbies? I think that's the weirdest line I've ever heard on a cooking show. See, that's why we don't watch the Food Network.
Yes.
Jimmy Frick says, binge watched all the Box Mac episodes. Now I have to wait for new ones to come out. This is macaroni and hell.
I like it.
Josh Mello Shedder says, I don't think a show about mac and cheese would be a staple in my life, but it is. How about that? Westroad Sal says, when you know you get addicted to a channel and you watch every... I believe this is Sal Cento yet again.
Yep.
When you're addicted to a channel and you watch every single video on that channel and then watch every single video on that channel again while very impatiently waiting for a new video on that channel, I'm talking about this channel. Box Mac. What's in Jun's Cart? I'm even watching the video vlogs from the making of movies. Great job, guys. I would send you Annie's mac and cheese, but that's my favorite, but I know you guys don't like them. Lol.
Lol.
And he would have commented on that before we even actually tried them. And proved that we don't really much care for them.
Yes.
Token McSweetleaf.
I like that name.
Says, the issue with the Macs that, was that you shouldn't have cooked them with a lid on. The water needed to boil off, FYI. He was talking about the camping Macs.
He's probably right. He actually probably was right about that. I will give you full credit. He has been in the camp before.
Furyx Jerlobi says, Junt's accent ebbs and flows like the tides. That is my favorite part of the series. You have a Massachusetts accent when yeah. it's appropriate. Yeah. You have a neutral accent yeah. when it's appropriate. And you also have a British affect that you put on when you were much younger. And you told me when I first met you, I was like, is he actually English? And they're like, no. And I was like, John, why do you have an English accent? And he goes, because people are nicer to English people.
They are. It's true. If you talk to everybody with a little, just a little bit of a British accent, which is what I do.
It's disarming.
Usually, it's disarming. It engages people more.
Kitty Friend, who we've mentioned before, says, yep. I read this one to my dad. This really captured his imagination. I used to eat cold Chef Boyardee Mac straight from the can. I'd wake up hungover, surrounded by the Mac cans. It was a dark time. That pull tab on the can makes it way too easy. My dad goes, what about that? He goes, that right there is a story.
It is.
Oh, Jesus. You just pull the tab off.
I just start spooning it.
Knowing how gross it is cold.
I've had it cold. I had it in that. We just wondered a little bit, and it was like, oh, man.
Oh, noodle, oh, noodle.
Oh, noodle, oh, noodle.
Libertine Sphinx says, you should do videos on your DVD collection. What he's talking about is, you can see very briefly in the Christmas special when I did my Turn and Smile
yeah.
for the sitcom theme, my DVD wall is behind me.
Yeah.
We've mentioned I have a massive collection.
Incredible wall.
He wants to see maybe a video on my collection.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll do
fun.
One sometime.
Yep.
Brian Mahoney says, is this Junt's house? What is Junt's day job? We've addressed this in a different episode.
Yeah, but this is my house. This is, I do live here. Yep.
And you designed this whole place.
I did. I designed it. Yep.
And you develop firmware for printers and...
Test systems for industrial printers. Yeah. Yep. And software as well. And that's what I do for my day job.
So we're both in the IT slash computer...
Computing field, yeah. I think.
Sebionti says, so much effort goes into it. I wish you guys get the views you truly deserve in 2016.
Oh, thank you.
Jack says, came across a new item at CVS called the Electric Mac and Cheese Maker. Rapid Mac, better watch its back.
Look, I've seen this device. I've heard about it. I was informed. Agents let me know. But it's expensive. Big bucks. And I looked at the concept. I think we're going to have to get it now.
We have to now.
But it was... I can already tell it's not something I'm ever going to use again.
Marcus, it's got like weird characters in the username. John is almost as fat as an American. Now,
does he not know how Americans work? Does he not know that we are Americans?
Yeah, I responded simply with, he is Dutch.
That's excellent.
People love Wee Will Weezum. In the camping Mac, you got a little lost for words.
Where was Weezum? Where was Weezum? Where was Weezum?
Lots of requests for us to make a Macumentary.
Yeah.
They want a documentary about mac and cheese.
I think it would be really interesting.
We mentioned it jokingly, yep. And now we got to do it, I guess. Now, if they come through on the Kickstarter
yep.
in a big, bad way.
Yeah.
And we get some stretch goals and we go really far out there.
Yeah, I think we could totally do it.
You could put enough money in our pockets to make
yeah,
us do that.
I could get behind that.
Josh Kleiner, on that same note, said, there's an article about mac and cheese on Smithsonian.com that says Kraft introduced its box mac and cheese in 1937.
Yeah, that's right.
It also says Thomas Jefferson served it at a state dinner in 1802. Maybe you could dig up some old recipes somewhere.
That would be fun. Like the original Jefferson mac, yeah.
Marie Josie Nadeau says, I love your show. I eat KD more than ever. I am Canadian. Mm-hmm. I found a 1958 Kraft mac and cheese commercial at a nickel per serving. This would be great for your future documentary world premiere on the orange carpet.
Oh, I like that.
Saw cute. Some genuine interest in John having a proper cooking show. So we laughed about you maybe having a proper cooking
yeah.
show. And there was some genuine interest in that.
I don't know if it would be that interesting, but...
And that's about it for the feedback. As far as future,
so much feedback. That's great.
We've got a ton of future shows.
Yeah, we had a production meeting recently. We went through and
Baby Food Max.
Yeah.
More from the Chicago Box, of yeah. course.
UK Max, which we've been teasing for a long time, but it's coming.
This one I'm most excited about. Yeah. Max John needs to bring to Frankie's attention.
Yes.
Because it's a surprise, apparently.
The Max that have fallen off your radar, and I'm going to bring them to your attention.
Mac Meals, you know, the cheeseburger skillets,
yes.
that sort of
yep.
thing.
Yep, we're going to give those a try.
Deli Max and Prepared Food Max.
So many great things, so many Macs we can try.
Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
So that's it for After Hours.
Yeah, well, I this was a lot of fun to go through everybody's comment. I hadn't heard a lot of these. So thank you, everybody, for sending in all your comments. Thank you for loving the show and watching with us. We really appreciate it.
If you continue doing it, we'll continue making them.
That's right. Next time on Box Mac.
What was it? Oh, noodle, oh, noodle.
Now sing with me.
Oh, no, noodle, oh, noodle. No, 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 no. No, 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 noodle, la, 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 la.
You get the idea.
Noodle, oh, noodle. It should go up again, right? Yeah.
And then you can go up a key.
We have not yet figured out oh, noodles. You get the idea.
You get the idea.
All right, this video is—it's a video signature for Alan Smithy. Since yes. We weren't prepared to take a photo and then sign the photo itself,
we don't have cameras.
I think is what you were requesting. We will sign the Rapid Mac for you. However, you'll get the video that proves that we got the email. I don't think your real name's Alan Smithy, by the way. That sounds like a guild name. If I know my movie trivia, John said something. Nina say something. So it's not just a cardboard cutout of you.
It is a cardboard cutout of pizza.
All right. Enjoy your rapid. Show us what you cooked in it.
Right. Hey, see ya. Great entry.
Josh James.
Josh James.
Josh James.
Josh James.
Josh James.
He did an incredible piece of art for
Amazing.
Us.
Amazing.
I still want the high res.
I want it framed in my kitchen.
Yeah, so we're going to do a few prints of that. We've been sharing it around. People love it. We're going to feature it on a future episode. Mm-hmm. You're obviously talented. I hope you stick around and maybe do more things for us as fun project ideas come up or as you come up with ideas. But thank you very much. We're signing your stuff right now, and we'll get it out to you.
Enjoy the rapid fee and noodles.
Oh, noodle. Oh, noodle.